come here today in the presence of God to witness and bless the joining together of this man and woman in holy matrimony. The bond and covenant of marriage was established by God in creation. And our Lord Jesus Christ enjoyed this manner of life by his presence and first miracle at a wedding in Canaan of Galilee. It signifies to us the mystery of the union between Christ and his church and Holy Scripture commenced to be honored among all people. The union of husband and wife in heart, body, and mind is intended by God for their mutual joy, for the help and comfort given one another in prosperity and adversity. Therefore, marriage is not to be entered into advisedly or lightly, but reverently, deliberately, and in accordance for which it was instituted by God. Into this holy union, Amrit and Bernadin now come to be joined. If any of you can show just cause why they may not lawfully be married, speak now, or else forever hold your peace. And I require and charge you both, here in the presence of God, that if either of you know any reason why you may not be united in marriage lawfully, in accordance with God's word, you should now confess it. And I'll ask this of you. And if you agree and affirm, I ask that you say, I will. Bernadette, will you have this man to be your husband to live together in the covenant of marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live? To live together in the covenant of marriage, you can say as many times as you want. Will you love her, comfort her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live? And will all of you witnessing these promises do all in your power to uphold these two persons in their marriage? If so, please respond by saying, a hearty, we will.
We will.
Let us pray. O gracious and ever-living God, you have created us male and female in your image. Look mercifully upon this man and this woman who come to you seeking your blessing, and assist them with your grace that with true fidelity and steadfast love, they may honor and keep the promises and vows they make. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Our reading this afternoon, actually, it's from the book of Mark. But from the beginning of creation, God made them male and female. For this reason, a man shall leave his father and mother and join to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh. So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, let no one separate. On behalf of Amrit and Bernadin, I welcome you, friends, family, to this wonderful and joyous occasion if they get married to each other. This isn't the beginning of a life together. That began probably the first time they laid eyes on each other. And that was sort of the beginning. And then who knows, tumultuous ups and downs or whatnot, or who knows what it was, or some combination in between. Well, this is just a symbol of your continuing journey. And an important one, of course, as I tell people, marriage changes things. Because you're coming before God, before each other, or before friends and family, taking vows to each other. And I'm very serious when you ask that question, will you do all your power to support them? Because sometimes they need that support. You know, it takes a village to raise a child, it takes a village to raise a marriage as well. And sometimes they need to be reminded of the vows they made to each other and their commitment, no matter what happens, good times, bad times, rich or poor, you name it, sickness and in health, they're there for each other. And so sometimes they just need to be reminded of that. Gently, perhaps, but sometimes, jokingly, they say it's like a 2x4 across the head, just amongst them, sends it to them. Because sometimes in the busyness of life, it's easy, it's all too easy to forget even the thing we cherish so much about each other. So today we come to celebrate alongside both of you. Now, what I'd like for you to do now, if you'll take her right hand and your right hand, just go like this, and in a moment I will switch positions. But right now, this is your act of will, saying this, and I just ask to repeat after me. In the name of God,
in the name of God,
I am going to take your burden.
I am going to take your burden
to be my wife. to have to hold,
to have to hold
from this day forward,
from this day forward,
for better for worse,
for better for worse,
for richer for poorer,
for richer for poorer,
and sickness and in health,
and for sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish,
to love and to cherish,
until we are parted by death,
until we are parted by death.
This is my song of love.
This is my song of love.
Okay. Now release hands. Go to the cues and move right hand. So again, this is just that intention that you do. In the name of God.
In the name of God.
I burn it into King Amrit.
I burn it into Amrit.
To be my husband.
To be my husband.
To have it to hold.
To have it to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better for worse.
For better for worse.
For richer for poorer.
For richer for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my song of love.
This is my song of love.
Bless the Lord, these rings to be signs of the vows by which this man and this woman have bound themselves to each other through Jesus Christ our Lord. Now that Amrit and Bernadin have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, with the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of the rings, I pronounce that they are husband and wife in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now we ask you to hold hands once again. And what I'm doing now is what's called the blessing. And what I'm doing is wrapping the stole, which is a symbol of priesthood, but also, more importantly, the symbol of the church, wrapping your commitment to each other in God's blessing, and asking God's blessing to be upon you as you journey upon this marvelous adventure we've decided to embark on. Oh God, you have so consecrated the covenant of marriage that it is represented the spiritual unity between Christ and his church. Send, therefore, your blessing upon these, your servants, that they may so love, honor, and cherish each other in faithfulness and patience, in wisdom and true godliness, that their home may be a haven of blessing and peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. It's my pleasure to introduce you to you this marvelous young couple as they begin their journey in Christ and go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Okay, now.